Hello guys, this is Sajid. Welcome again to our channel Artisans Web. In today's video, we are going to see how to protect our WordPress site against brute force attack. So this is the blog I have written on the same topic, where I have discussed some steps one should follow to protect their site. So what is mean by brute force attack? So here you can read about it. Brute force attack is a method where attacker tries to gain access site by trying username and password. Means they have the system where they try the different combination of username and password. So means what I can say, you should set means strong username and password. This is the first step to protect our website. And again, attacker uses software through which it takes just a few minutes to try few hundreds of combination. Yeah, within a some second or some minutes, they try the thousands of different combination of username and password. So they have a clever system which can break your website by the correct combination of username and password. So to avoid this such case of attack, we should follow some steps for our WordPress site. So let's see what steps we can apply. So first step you should apply is change WordPress login URL. So as we all know, WordPress is an open source, so everyone knows default login page of WordPress can access at here, your site URL slash wp-login.php, or another one is your site URL slash wp-admin. So it will again redirect to wp-login.php file. So let's see how we can change that default admin URL. So as mentioned here, this is the plugin which help us to change our default admin URL of our WordPress. So this is my password. I have already installed that plugin. Just I show you is how we can, one can change the admin URL. So I go to plugin page. I first activate that plugin, and then we change our admin URL from setting page. So activate it. Go to settings page. So here, yeah, it's showing default web admin because I have tried this already. You can change any unique admin URL here, and make sure means that URL should be unique and no one can assume that admin URL. So in my case, I set it to web admin and click on save changes. Web admin is also common. Try to make something like different and some hard name for your admin URL. So as it's just demo purpose, so I set it to web admin. Now log out. Now let's see what is our default admin URL. Show us. Now I type wp admin. WordPress has been, yeah, this has been disabled. WordPress disabled this URL. Now let's try wp-login.php. Again, page not found. So in this case, your default WordPress provided admin URL will not work. So it is very good because attacker will never know what is your admin URL is. So there is no chances of trying different combinations of username and passwords. So this one is first step. Next one is set strong username and password. Yeah. Never ever use your username as admin and password as 123456. Never. try to set unique username and hard password. Means I show you, means from your profile page you can set the difficult password using the inbuilt WordPress system. So go to profile page and click on generate password. Yeah, this is some kind of different password and it is not easy to break such kind of password. So this is the another step. Now next one is limit access to WP admin by IP. Yeah, so let's say you are the only person who are accessing your site dashboard. So in that case you can add this rule in your htaccess file. I copy it and paste after end password, and here just set your static IP address. Make sure to follow this step. You must have static IP addresses, because after adding this rule only that IP address can access your WP admin URL. So make sure you have static IP address and you are the only person who has access to your dashboard, and just replace this placeholder with your IP addresses. You can allow one more user, or you have the one more person who also handling your dashboard, then you can set their IP addresses here as well. So there is no restriction on it, means you can give the more user access of your WP dashboard. It is up to you how many IP addresses you have to give access to. So this is the another step you can follow. Next one is password protect WP login.php file. Yeah, this is the step, means it's kind of HTTP authentication. It add the extra layer to your WP login.php file. If you want to follow this step, you can read about this article. I will place this link in the video description below. Okay, it just means kind of HTTP authentication, means before accessing your WP login.php file, browser will access, will prompt you to enter your username and password which you set in your HTTP password file. Okay, you can read more about this on this link. Next one is use captcha on login form. Yeah, it is better idea to use captcha on your login form, because it can slow down the attack the brute force attack, because while trying the combination of username and password they need to break captcha as well. So it is very good idea. You can try any plugin from WordPress repository, add captcha to login form. Yeah, there are different plugins available which allow you to add captcha on your login form. Okay, you can give a try to whatever you feel better. Login no captcha. So this one is another steps, and this is use two-factor authentication. Yeah, this two-factor authentication is nothing but it's kind of two-way. While entering username and password, system will send message on your mobile address as well, and then by matching the both password then only user can get access to your dashboard. So about this you can read on wordpress.org how to apply a two-step authentication, how to install and configure two-factor authentication. So there are different ways one can use to apply two-step authentication. So it is means out of our scope of this video to show you which method is better or whatever. You can give a try to anyone, and whatever you feel they right, you can choose it. So yeah, so it's all about protecting our WordPress against the brute force attack. So I hope you understand the tutorial. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave a comment below. Thanks for watching video. Have a nice day.